Welcome to the PostConfigurator video training session. My name is Thomas and I will guide you through the first session, which is like an introduction to the product PostConfigurator. First, we take an overview about the concept of PostConfigurator and the philosophy behind it. Then we will talk about the installation and configuration and which license models PostConfigurator is using. After that, we will go over to the layer concept of PostConfigurator and the different configuration levels and how you can use your own templates and reuse it. This session will end with some hints how you can help yourself and where you can find further documentation. So, let us start. What is PostConfigurator? PostConfigurator is a new, easy-to-use and integrated development tool for post-processors within NXCAM. So you can start it in NXCAM and work in an integrated environment. For example, to change a post and directly post it to validate the result. PostConfigurator promotes a reuse instead of rewrite. That means it's not needed to reinvent the wheel for new posts. You can reuse TCL code from other posts or create your own layers. PostConfigurator uses a layer concept instead of one monolithic file. As a post developer, this gives the advantage to have a structure to provide very fast post processor to the end customer. PostConfigurator separated the core functionality from customization. This means Siemens will provide you standard procedures and libraries which will work in the NX environment. The customization can be done through the layer concepts. Behind the PostConfigurator is the same underlying MOM architecture, so it is possible to reuse existing TCL procedures. PostConfigurator has a built-in protection for the created post. It's possible to timebomb the post. For example, for a demo post or to license the post to a special sold-to ID. PostConfigurator is not an extension of PostBuilder. It has an own concept, which is completely different to PostBuilder. So, what is the future of PostBuilder? All TCL posts, also the post created using PostBuilder, will continue to run and be supported. There are no plans to retire TCL, MOM, MOM event support or the underlying architecture. PostBuilder continues to be fully supported, maintained and enhanced, with bug fixes and new features as it has been until now. All out-of-the-box machines are being migrated to a PostConfigurator-based post, and also new samples are only PostConfigurator-based. In long term, we would help to existing customers to transition to the use of PostConfigurator-based post. So evaluate if when it will be possible to retire PostBuilder. Also, we work with customers and partners to formulate a clear strategy which is realistic for future. So, also, often customer asks, is it possible to migrate old posts to the new platform? PostConfigurator posts are completely differently structured than a PostBuilder post. A PostBuilder cannot open a PostConfigurator post. And PostConfigurator cannot open a PostBuilder post. At the moment, there is no automatic migration path or tool available. Do the same underlying interface with NX, MOM events and MOM variables. A lot of the PostBuilder source could be reused for PostConfigurator. If a post works fine currently, we do not recommend migrating at this time. But we recommend to use PostConfigurator for new posts. So, should PostConfigurator be used for new posts? Yes, for new machines we recommend using PostConfigurator, with the given limitations. Single channel, up to 5 axes, milling, turn and mill turn. With NX1201, you can also create multi-channel machines. Siemens PL would offer to support and help in this transition. What skills will developers need to create a new authoring environment or maintain their posts going forward? At the end, the same requirements as for Post Builder as underlying architecture is the same. So, what you need? TCL knowledge, the MOM event knowledge, and this training, the Post Configurator knowledge. On this slide, you see the roadmap of Post Configurator. Started with minimal features in NX10.02, we get in more and more features to complete the Post Configurator, with all the things you need to develop fast and efficient post processors for your customer. The latest features for NX1201 are the UDE editor to edit and create user-defined events. We have introduced a layer viewer, which allows to get an user interface, and you can take a look at the used layers and in which order they are used. Performance is an ongoing task in each release. There are a lot of discussion about the performance, but in short the statement is, yes, you need a few more seconds when posting short toolpaths in comparison to Post Builder or other TCL posts. But for longer toolpaths, you win a lot of time if you are using the Turbo mode, which is a standard implementation in Post Configurator libraries. We will get back to this later in the training. One important thing to know is that the libraries we deliver are backwards compatible. That means a post which is created in NX1201 can execute in NX versions from NX9 and also in NX8.5, with some limitations. This gives you the possibility to develop the post with newest NX version and latest feature, even if customer has an older version. For future, we plan to implement a new debugging tool, a layer import-export functionality and other features, which makes Post Configurator smarter, so that you can develop the post for customer fast. Which license types are available for Post Configurator? For Post Configurator, we have three license types. The basic license is free and included in NXCAM. The user can only execute post processors created by Post Configurator. With the advanced license, you can execute post processors and create new post processors. This license allows to change settings in the Post Configurator user interface. And also, this license is generally available for all users which have a Post Builder license. The full license is recommended for everyone who want to develop post processors with additional customization of TCL and want to protect and encrypt posts. It includes advanced debugging functionality to customize post output and to customize the user interface of Post Configurator. On this slide, you see an overview in which bundle the Post Configurator Advanced License is included for new customers. As I mentioned before, existing customers have automatically the Post Configurator Advanced License if they have Post Builder. The Post Configurator tool is available from NX1001 and up. To use it, you need the license I mentioned before. If you have an older license file, you need to update the license file, which includes the new license bit. For Post Configurator, no additional installation is required. Post Configurator is included in NXCAM. We recommend to use the latest version of NX to develop post processors with Post Configurator. It will give you the newest features for development of post. And remind, the post is backward compatible to older versions. What maybe not works is to develop a post with the latest Post Configurator user interface version and then reopen it in an earlier version with Post Configurator. Because the user interface of Post Configurator is not backward compatible. Only the post itself can execute in earlier versions. So, let's take a look about the overview functionality of Post Configurator. In general, if you want to open an existing post or you want to create a new post processor, you have a small dialog in NX. In this list, you will only see a post configurator post. And for example, if a post is created, then you will also see it directly here in the list. We will do it in a few seconds. As a note, this list will only show post configurator post processors, not post builder posts. So switch to NX. For example, with NX 1102, most of our out-of-the-box simples are migrated to post configurator posts. So for example, open the sim8, and if you want to open the post configurator post, then you have first one to open it in the ribbon bar here. So means you have this post configurator, just click it and the dialog is open. As you can see, this is the post behind this machine, but you can also browse for different post processors. So just for example, go to the math folder and the resource library machine installed machines. For example, the sim8 here again. You can see in this post processor folder of the sim8, you have a FANUC post and you have a FANUC post configurator. That means post configurator are the new post configurator posts. And the FANUC is the old post builder post. So they are still there and are not removed. As you can see, post configurator posts have the file extension PSC. So that means if I go to the sim numeric post configurator, I can choose this file and open the post from here. If you go to the post builder post, you don't have this PSC file here, and so you cannot open it. So, if you don't see this post configurator button here in the ribbon bar, then it's maybe on the role you have. So just go to the roles and to the content here and switch to KM Advanced, then you will see it in the ribbon bar here. Also, you can open the post configurator from the menu, tools and machine tool utilities, and then you have here the post configurator and it opens the dialog. So just open the existing one for a first impression of it. Just open it and now I get the user interface of post configurator. So in general, you have three main groups in the post configurator UI. The left side, that is what we named configuration objects. That means these are groups of settings for the post processors. So, like groups for cycle settings, like groups for motion settings, general motion settings, general output settings. This is just to get a structure in your post. On the right side, you see here, this is what we named properties. So, for each thing you can set up, you have a property. And these are the individual settings of the post processor. And the third one, these are the actions bars. And here you can perform actions on your post, like showing changes to the post and or encrypt the post processor. So let me switch back to the NX here. As you can see, the slide is a little bit older and you have a little bit more actions here. I will tell something about the details in a few seconds. And what you also have is you have a search bar here. So that means you can search for things like you want to, or you search some things for cycle 800. So I just type in cycle 800 and all the properties which are dealing with cycles I can do it are in the list here now. So, and for example, I am interested in the direction parameter. So just click it and it switch automatically to the property in the UI. And yeah, that you can do, for example, also like home position, just search it and it's marked here. You have also for the full license, you have a filter setting in the top. I will explain something to it later, but at the end it's only available with the full version. And in this version you can set up the different three types of version, and you will see properties which are only, for example, visible in the full version or only should be visible in the advanced version. That depends on the post developer. But for example, when I now switch to basic, or let's full. For example, full, I have this debugging options here. If I switch it to the basic, I don't have any more debugging options, and that is what the user with a basic license will see. So, but because I have the full license, I can switch it. But it's important, because if you want to create own properties and you maybe don't want that other users with a normal advanced license can see these properties, you can hide them in the property definition. This will be part of the advanced modifications in a later session. So, some things about the single items in the user interface. The first one, this is the reset customization. This will reset all changes done through the post configurator UI. What does that mean? For example, I changed here this property to on, and when I now put on this reset button and go back to this debugging, then it's reset to the origin state. The second one, findbar, I show it, a search file to find any keyword in the UI. So just type some things like this home positions again, or the tool, because we have the home position, the tool change, and I get, for example, G&M codes or general settings for the tool change. That's a search bar. Then we have a context help. That means every property have a context help. So this one, that means it's a short description of the property and what it means for what it is. And it's for each property, it's different. We have an inheritance control. Inheritance control means, for example, if we create a new post, normally home positions have a standard value of 99,999. And if you set up this value, then this is unlocked here. So, and what you can do is, I can say, okay, I want to inherit the custom value again. So just click it and I get my old value, or the standard value when the post was created. If I now change this value, for example, to 1, then it's unlocked, and also, and that is what you see then, it's changed. It changed here. So, and if you want to see all the changes of in this post, for example, you have this information, show changes. Just click it, and I have to move it over to the screen here. And a listing window is open with all the things which are changed in this post in the user interface of Post Configurator. The third one, or another thing, is this integrated TCL editor. That means here you see all the TCL files which are included in this post and can be added by the user. So just select it, and then you can open it with the internal TCL editor, and you get the content of the file and so on. You can add new things and so on. Yeah. Just click OK to close it. Then you have here this encryption and encryption button, only available in the full license. With this, there's a new dialog, and now you can encrypt your post. You can say I want to set up expiration date for the post, or the post is only available for some SOL2 IDs. For example, the SOL2 ID from your customer. If you use the SOL2 ID, don't forget to enter your own ID. Otherwise, it's not possible that you execute the post. And also, just for example, you want to set up an expiration date to one of the next days. Just set it up and then it's done. But in deep, the encryption will also a separate session in this videos. Okay, so what are the other action buttons here? This is a post process button. That means you can directly post from here. For example, just select the operation here, so face stop, and post it. And then a listing window is open directly. If you can, or maybe you see it when if you use earlier versions of NX before 12.01. Before 12.01, a dialog was open to show the post processor again. Now it's switched that this, if you click this post process button, the listing window directly open with the output, and it's output in a temporary file. You can see it here, it's in the UGII temp dir, and it's then named post process preview and the extension PTP. So the reason is that you normally don't post directly from the post configurator for normal machine operations. You post from here to validate your changes in the post and so on. And that is why we change it to a temporary output file here. Then you have the definition file editor. It's also later on a separate training session. There you can edit block templates, addresses, formats. You have this user-defined event editor here, where you can create new user-defined events, you can duplicate them, you can change them. And also we have this layer manager here, which shows layers are used in this post and so on. Then you have the show changes, and you have a save button just to save the post and the settings or the changes you do. And you have a save as button. The save as button means you can save the post under a different name. And yeah, that's maybe you, for example, you have a like a master post and want to give this post to other customer, then use the save as button and save it under a different name, and it works directly. So here just a slide of the different things you can do in the user interface, which I mentioned before, this reset customization, find bar, context help, and a short description. So Now we go over to the concept of Post Configurator. So Post Processor is with Post Configurator more than one monolithic file now. It is split up in layers, and multiple layers with different functionality. Not every layer is always required. A layer can add new functionality, it can override existing functionality, a layer can be TCL code, and a layer can also be encrypted or protected. So what does it mean? You have like this basic layer. It contains for example generic things like file handling, like how to output in the listing window, how to use some calculations which are for all controllers are the same, and so on. Then you have a controller level. That means controller specific, for example Siemens, Fano, Kainhain, Okuma, and so on. All these files are encrypted and cannot be changed. Then you have a machine tool builder level, which contains the kinematic setup. And this MTB level will automatically be created by Post Configurator when you have a load a machine. And it will also create it when you don't have a machine in your CAM and you create the post processor. And then it will create with standard values. So then you have the layers, for example, the OEM layers or machine layers you can create. And you have a service layer, which contains at the end TCL-based modifications for that. And on the top, you have the customer layer. That means this layer contains all the things you changed in the user interface of Post Configurator. So, and the concept behind is that you can combine layers to a post. So, for example, you have a master post which standard functionality for a lot of different machines from different manufacturers, and some of them have, for example, additive features on, or you can do additive machining. Some have special functionalities for milling or drilling, and so on. So you can put this functionality into a layer, and now when a customer wants to have a post, you just can combine these layers with some clicks and create your post fast and efficient. So, and for example, like this DMG, DMU layers here, or just use a Fanuc without special customizations. So that is what you can do. And this templates, you can extend it, you can create your own templates, your own layers here, and can added to this post. So, and for example, this is a post with a lot of customizations, and you can see here most of the things are from customer itself. But you have this base controller MTB level, that is what we deliver from Siemens PLM. Then you have this customization level, which contains a lot of different layers, for example, a layer for custom procedures, a layer for the event handlers of the UDEs, a layer for error messages in a separate file. For headers or for some tool handling inside the post. And that is what I want to show here is you can add so much functionality into your post configurator post and can separate them. So if you don't need, for example, this headers here, just let it out of the post when you create it and then you have the standard output, or you change it with the different layers and or you extend this. And also, that is what you see here. For example, this GE buffer file. With this, you can override or extend functionality of the standard libraries. That means you cannot see what is in the controller or in the base, but you can extend the commands and you can override them also. So if you are not agree with, for example, implementation in it or something is missing, it's easy to extend it. So next slide is a little bit about the architecture and how you can find it in your Mach folder. So you have in the Mach folder you have a post configurator folder. This folder contains extension tools for the post configurator. For example, this TCL editor and this def editor. The TCL editor is Java-based and uses AIDS text editor. And it's possible to extend and customize this. For example, the auto-completion of commands inside the TCL editor or the documentation of MOM variables. Second one, the def editor. It's also Java-based. Also extendable, yes. And you have a folder named lib inside, and this contains encrypted TCL files with procedures which controls the user interface of post configurator and the data model inside of NX Core. And you have a second folder. It's also named post underlines configurator, and that is located in the Mach resource directory. And this folder contains all the post configurator standard libraries. So, for example, when you create a new post processor, you get this list of all the controllers which are inside the NX installation, and this is triggered through this post registry XML file. So what does it mean? That this post template folder contains the out of the box libraries for different controllers and machine manufacturer layers. At this time, with every NX release, Siemens PLM deliver new library versions which improve functionality and fixes for bugs. And I see, sorry, that's German.
Nein.
So there's a second folder for the post configurator. This is located under the Mach resource folder. And in this folder, you have a folder post template, and in this post template folder, you have all the out-of-the-box libraries for different controllers and machine manufacturer layers. At this time, with every NX release, Siemens PLM deliver new library versions which improve functionality and contains fixes for bugs. An update to newer versions is possible, for example, in the kit store or on request. And the post registry itself contains dependencies for the different controllers and layers. So that means when you create a new post processor, you have a list of the controllers here, for example, CNumeric 840D, and this also have dependencies to the manufacturer and machine level. So it means see it on the next slide. No, sorry, I think this slide. So last topic in this web session. In short, documentation where you can find topics about the post configurator and additional features, or if you have problems or something to discuss. So the first one is official NX help collection. I recommend the web-based documentation out of NX, and you have this online technical support there. You have the help in general for NX, and just search for post configurator and you find a lot of things, also documentation of the library commands and so on. You have this, for example, customizing post processors. You have different topics for that. For you can browse mom variables, mom commands, and it's a very good help. So the second one, if you have questions which maybe are not answered in the help, I recommend to use the NX manufacturing forum here. Just post it and you get an answer from the community. Third one, sometimes are small things, and maybe the small things are directly in the context help of post configurator itself. So just read the property descriptions, and maybe then your problem is solved after that. Okay, so thanks for attention, and goodbye.